Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. So glad you could join us on this Saturday night.
Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Chris Webber. David Aldridge is on our sidelines. We welcome eight-time All-NBA first-team player Shaquille O'Neal. And it probably could have been about 15 first-year, right?
It probably could have been about 15, but, you know, I was doing rap videos and didn't come into training camp in shape. Just really didn't care at time. But anyway, good to be here with you, Kevin. David, we'll see about Chris. You know what they used to say about the old Shaq, so he's out of shape. He's only averaging 29, but he's so out of shape.
He's out of shape.
Already it's February. Hard to believe. Let's see how the West is matching up. Taking a look at the Lakers. They're sitting pretty, second place, and looking to take the top spot.
And when I look at the Lakers, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
You know, that's the mindset you have to have. They know if they can get to the playoffs, they have the talent to do some real damage.
So the opening lineup for the Heat. Out on the perimeter, it's Robinson and Butler. In the middle, it's Olynyk and Adebayo. And it's Nunn in at the one spot. And for the Lakers, Caldwell Pope and LeBron fill out the wings. Kyle Kuzma is out there with Marc Gasol. And it's Schroeder in at the point guard position.
Shaq, you were such a prolific scorer back in the day. Right now, if you needed just one bucket to seal a game, win a game, who would you want taking that shot?
Well, that has to be my favorite player, Steph Curry. He's on the injury list. I'm going to have to go with James Harden. Younger Steph Curry would be Trae Young. Luka Doncic is right after Trae Young. Russell Westbrook is pretty good. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry, Mr. Kevin Durant.
I
apologize.
And Kelly Olynyk is going to pick up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Schroeder outside, and he drives in. The Heat on offense. It's a three-point game. Right wing. Here's Nunn. Really played well against Sacramento in his last outing. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
A gifted scorer around the rim. Olynyk can finish over either shoulder, and he's got great touch.
James, a screen on Nunn. Here's Schroeder. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's going to be on Bam Adebayo.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Lakers shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe.
And they've been ordinary on the season as well, just about 75% from the line.
Shoot two.
And he knocks down the first one. And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
Big fella, when you watch the NBA now, there are fewer traditional centers who just pounded inside. But what are your thoughts on how the five position, that center position, has evolved?
Well, it's all about, you know, having traditional size. You know, these guys are becoming great shooters. The range, I think that's a great combo to have. Guys like Embiid and Towns, they're the next wave of the five.
Now, here's Schroeder. His scoring has been there on a regular basis. He's averaging more than 14 points a game. The Heat have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Passes it to Olynyk. Floats it up for Butler. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. They push it up 4-on-3. Nice shot by James.
The sheer strength of LeBron, the King James. Excellent at staying in control, even when the defense is aggressive.
Now, here's Nunn. The scoring numbers have been solid for him. He's averaging just under 14 points a game. Here's Butler. And again, it's the Heat missing.
Nice interior defense. Can't give him any space inside or he'll burn them.
Caldwell poke right side. James against Robinson. Nice shot by James. LeBron's got his second basket of the game.
See, I like LeBron James' activity right there, Kevin. He has the size and the touch to score at will.
Pass to Adebayo. James against Butler. The shot by Adebayo, no good. And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Lakers.
Well, Shaq, you are a blue chipper, but Duncan Robinson, back in high school, figured he'd be lucky to play college basketball. The road less traveled has brought him, though, to the NBA.
Yeah, he went to Phillips Exeter Academy, Williams College, then Michigan, then the G League, and guess what? He's now an NBA starter. All you kids out there, never give up on your dreams.
If you can shoot, you can do it, right?
That's right.
And he can shoot.
He sure can.
Here's Nunn. Following the basket by LeBron James. Driving the lane, Nunn. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you had to bring much faster help than that.
Now, here's Kuzma. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Gasol passes to James. Shot clock at 5. Throws it down as the official calls the foul. It may be a 3-point play. It's on Jimmy Butler.
Listen, you can't expect that foul to shut down the King. He's too talented, too powerful.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. The Lakers making a switch here. Harrell's checked in. Hero's checked in for Miami.
Find the lane. Find the lane. One shot.
James, no good on the free throw.
Now, even in the later stages of his career, Kevin, James is just focused on one thing. That's winning as many championships as he can.
Here's Hero. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. Nunn can't get it to fall. Los Angeles leading by 3.
And you look at the news every day, so much division. Commissioner Adam Silver has talked about basketball and sports really in general as a unifying force. And Shaq, it definitely does bring us together.
You know, the NBA is a melting pot. It's not about where you're from or what language you speak. It's all about teamwork, discipline, and respect. And I've always said there's two things, despite what you have going on in the world, especially stressful, there's two things that have shut all that down. Music and sports.
They always do it. But isn't it great to be associated with the league that is on the forefront of those kinds of things?
I don't know about that, but it's great to be associated with you and Greg.
How nice is that? Yeah.
I mean, I'm getting
I've been waiting to come down here for years.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful.
Kenny and Ernie. Ha 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 ha.
Both teams deciding to change it up. Shaq, you stayed at LSU 3 years, played 3 years of college basketball, but went back and completed your degree, which was terrific. Then you pursued training and degrees in other fields. What draws you
so much to continuing education?
You know, you always want to keep improving yourself. You know, I owed it to myself and my family to complete my degree. You know, I'm famous for saying I got 4 degrees. Would you like to know?
Yes.
Bachelor's, master's, doctorate, and street.
Which one, what's the most valuable of those?
The street.
Yes.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
And here is James. He's got 8. With the drive. Shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot 2 free throws.
Too powerful, too athletic. James gets fouled on the drive. 1 more off than it's called.
And he's just had 1 attempt at the line earlier.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for him.
Well, the GOAT watch continues. Every year, every accomplishment goes into the analysis. I mean, LeBron would probably never be able to escape it.
And James drills them both. The Heat trail by 3. Here's Strus. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. Now here's Harrell.
More and more teams going to small ball, but Shaq, we still have big guys who affect winning because they throw their weight around inside. They make their presence known. Who leads the way when you think of that group?
Greek Freak, Andre Drummond, Joel Embiid, Rudy Gobert, Clint Capella.
How do you come up with these names
DeMarcus
so quickly?
I am still the reigning president of the Big Man Alliance.
You
Anything
are.
Big
you
man don't. I know. All these guards and foo-foo pick-and-pop players, I don't know who they are. When it comes to the BMA, the Big Man Alliance, I am still the reigning president.
Shooting 2.
That's good from Harrell. Matthews, he's checked in for James. And both free throws good for Harrell. The Heat trail by 5. Pass to Achiuwa. Heat moving the ball around. Strus. Off target with his 3. Here's the Lakers with the ball. They're on a 16-6 run. Morris with the screen for Harrell. It's good for his 2nd make. He's made 2 of 3 so far.
The dogged intensity Harrell has is just insane. And he uses all this energy to his advantage, particularly on the glass.
Here's Hero, and it's good for 2.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
Caruso, the pass to Harrell. They set the pick. It's hauled in by the Heat.
A fantastic effort on D to get up in his face and deny the layup.
52 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Kicks it out to Iguodala. Clock at 6. Top of the key. Misses off the right iron. Lakers leading by 5. Wesley Matthews on the wing. No points in the game yet for him. 24 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Harkless the pass to Hero. To the wing on the left. Here's Strus. Connects from 3-point range.
That's just a product of good pass work. I mean, nice team basketball right there.
Here's Caruso to the paint. Harrell, that's good. Harrell's got 8 points.
And improving as a shot maker every year, Harrell has to be accounted for defensively.
And so it's LeBron James making things happen for Los Angeles. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. We've got more in store for you right after this. Well, Greg, we know he's already a solid scorer, but Kyle Kuzma spoke to us before the game about evolving his game.
Biggest area of growth would definitely be on the defensive end and my playmaking ability. This year, I'm just trying to be a consistent defender, find my teammates, because I have so much attention offensively. So I think those are two areas.
Now, having played with superstars, Kuzma is learning what it takes to win.
He's getting only so many shots per game. So I applaud him for finding other ways to contribute to his team with an eye toward the greater goal.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Lakers?
Well, they've carried out a great game plan in the paint so far, working it down low a lot and getting high percentage looks.
And they're also clicking at the free throw line, not wasting any of those opportunities.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. Taking a look at the Lakers. LeBron and Kuzma make up the forwards. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Caldwell Pope, and Harrell's in at the five down low.
And the big man, Anthony Davis, leaving the team that drafted him to be a part of a superstar duo with the Lakers. Shaq, does that at all sound familiar?
Yeah, listen, you know, some drama was made about the way he got to the West Coast, but hopefully he can collect those rings.
One shot.
Just like I did with the Lakers. Look, you know, the first spot for him was a struggle, and he said, you know what, I want to be with a contender. I think I'm a great player. So I wish him very well.
None with it. And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. Adebayo with a screen on Schroeder. Got a piece of it. Here's Nunn on target from 13 feet. Nunn's got 6.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range, even against that length.
Yeah, the defender just couldn't quite close the gap all the way and got burned for it.
James and the dunk by James.
Listen, it's a lot of physical defense out there, but once LeBron gets going down here, sayonara, move, get out the way.
Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played. On a screen on Kuzma. Olynyk. Good D by Gasol. And here's Caldwell Pope. He brings it up for the Lakers. 7-point game, the biggest lead in the game. Caldwell Pope with a screen for Schroeder. And Dennis Schroeder gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. And talking about how awards are determined, people claim there's a level of voter fatigue, so many things to vote for, and without much meaning. If there's something you could change, Shaq, about the process of all that voting, what would it be?
I think I would probably have the players. The players should have a little bit more say in who wins the awards. And I think you give voice to people who have actually stepped on the court. And we have a lot of legends that played the court. I think we should, you know, create this thing of ours. And you would definitely be included because me and you have been around since 1989. It's also the first year I met Ernie Johnson.
No
wow.
kidding. Yeah.
The Mount
it just
Rushmore
hit me.
Broadcasting.
It just hit me.
And the recognition Gasol has is tremendous. I mean, you can't leave anyone open or he'll find them.
The Heat trail by 6. Now Robinson. He's making his presence felt offensively with his scoring average up there at almost 13 points a game. None against Schroeder. Great D that time from Dennis Schroeder. Los Angeles leading by 6. And that one is good.
And the lead should be safe if they can keep shooting the basketball like this.
Looking at Miami, they took their win in their last game against Sacramento. Adebayo kicks to Butler. Takes a three. The shot, no good. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Coming off that loss against the Nets.
You know, I don't like to use the word shock, but that was a shocking result for me. Nobody saw that one coming. To lose to that team was surprising enough, but to get blown out like that?
Almost beyond belief. I mean, even on a bad night, you think they'd at least be competitive.
Three-pointer, Butler, they get the rebound. Here's Olynyk, plays it up and banks it in. Olynyk's got his second bucket.
Oh, I love that aggressiveness from Olynyk. I mean, he can create his own offense. I mean, we all know that, but that time with a little cleanup work.
Here's Schroeder. Let's see some of the numbers here for Bam Adebayo.
The surge in his free throw percentage this month is noticeable. He's looked a lot more comfortable at the line. Part of his job now should be attacking the D, going head on, drawing fouls, and trying to ride this hot streak.
First free throw is good. Achiuwa, he's checked in for Miami. Hero comes in for Robinson. So after making the first, he goes one for two. The Heat trail by 10. Here's Hero. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against the Kings in Sacramento. Shots good from Butler.
Oh, not lacking confidence from this area. Butler feels like he can get his shot off anytime he wants.
LeBron dishes to Gasol. And the pass to Schroeder. Over Nunn. It's hauled in by Hero.
I thought that one was going to go down. The mid-range jumpers? Oh, man, that's usually a bunny with the D playing soft like that.
Here's Butler. That one goes. Count it. Butler's got 7 points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
LeBron a screen on Nunn. It's Schroeder with the drive. The basket is good. That's his 6th attempt and his 3rd make. The Heat trail by 8. And here's Nunn. 6 points for him. Outside Butler. And that'll be Miami as it goes out of bounds. The Heat retain possession. And some changes here for the Lakers. Matthews comes in for James. And it's Alex Caruso in for Dennis Schroeder. Heat also with a sub. Andre Iguodala is checked in for Kendrick Nunn. Iguodala kicks to Butler. Just 5 on the clock. And they pick up 2.
Hey, he's got the hot hand right now. As long as he can keep getting open, they've got to keep feeding him.
Caruso, the pass to Matthews. Gasol, a screen on Butler. Matthews. Jimmy Butler comes up with the rebound. The Heat trail by 6. Here's Adebayo. Can't hit that one.
That works just like they drew it up. Until the part where he short arms the layup.
Passes it to Gasol. Here's Caruso. Shot from 12. And it's Iguodala with the rebound. Knocked away. Matthews with it, and it's Iguodala picking him up. And Matthews throws it down.
Well, they weren't going to pass up that chance to get out and run following the steal.
Here's Hero. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. Here's Butler. That's in, coming off an assist from Adebayo. Butler's got 8 points here in this quarter.
And this is why Butler is an efficient offensive player. Takes smart shots, within the offensive game plan.
And Shaq, a pleasure to have you with us. Great to hear your observation as always. I hope you join us again.
I will. Happy to give them any time. I appreciate you guys. Love you guys very much.
Man, they really are chomping at the bit to get you back up there.
Yeah, they want you back in the studio.
Nope, I'd rather be here with you guys.
Good. We want you here too. And Chris, you think about Shaq's ability to raise his game under the spotlight. We're seeing him do that as an analyst with us here at courtside.
I mean, this is a guy who led the Lakers to three consecutive titles, during which he had the highest scoring average for a center in NBA Finals history. I mean, big fella steps up in his counter.
Lakers leading by three. Now, here's Matthews. Caruso, the pass to Morris. Shot clock at six. Gasol finds Matthews. Gasol setting the pick for Matthews. Count it. And the Lakers lead by five.
That's a perfect setup. Solid screen. Defender can't avoid it. Opens up a clear path to the bucket.
Here's Hero. Here's Adebayo. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Adebayo's got 7 points.
Second chance points kill you. It's a strength of Adebayo, picking up the garbage and putting it in.
And some good action through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Lakers ahead, up by three. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you enjoyed the competitive first half of action. Ernie Johnson here welcoming you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. That guy right there is Shaquille O'Neal, and that guy right there is Kenny the Jet Smith. And making the long walk back from the courtside broadcasting booth, the esteemed and somewhat winded Shaquille O'Neal.
Very funny, Ernie. I'm not tired. I took the elevator.
Great elevator.
Watch your mouth, kid.
All right, that was Keith.
Give this man some mouth-to-mouth.
Oh, not me.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game that's been so far. It's been a clinic out there by James.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And as they can't slow him down, you know what you do? You keep feeding them and feeding them and feeding them. This is the right game plan.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. On the court for the Heat, out on the perimeter, it's Robinson and Butler. In the middle, it's Olynyk and Adebayo. And it's Nunn in at the point. Today, Greg, we see a lot more friendly rivals. Does that bother you?
Not at all. I mean, people like to say, well, our era had the rivalries were more bitter. I disagree with that. I think guys are every bit as competitive today as they've ever been.
That's good to hear.
They just also have more exposure and opportunity to be around one another. Kids today growing up, they've been playing against each other since the fifth, sixth grade in national tournaments. When we played, we didn't get to see the other top players around the country. So I think that was one reason why you didn't have a closeness with guys that unless you were on the same team.
You know, even though LeBron doesn't go 100% every minute of every game in the season, GA, he still knows when to turn it on.
And for someone at his age, that is something you have to know how to do. You can see when LeBron kicks it into that next gear. Can't keep it on all the time, but he's still able to take over when he needs to. And LeBron James, still the face of the league as he goes into his mid-30s.
the impact he's had on this sport is really immeasurable.
Come on, G.A. I mean, he's one of the most recognizable athletes in the world. I mean, it's scary to think that LeBron can still turn it on and take over when he needs to. And you know what? Playoff LeBron is a very real thing.
Outside Butler, here's Adebayo. And Adebayo throws it down.
Oh, look, if you're open, Butler will find you. His court awareness, very impressive.
Schroeder outside.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Nunn looking around. Dishes it to Robinson. Six on the shot clock. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Kuzma finds Schroeder. Lakers passing it around. Kuzma passes to Gasol. Now here's LeBron. Gasol, a screen on Robinson. And James throws it down hard.
Come on, Hall of Fame athleticism and ability. James has no problem throwing it down in style.
Nunn passes to Butler and slam dunk by Butler.
Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that deuce.
Harrell, he's checked in for Los Angeles. And Miami with a change here, too. Harkless is checked in for Butler. And here's James. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. That'll be the last of three straight at home for the team. Here's Harrell, and Harrell slams it in. Guys, close one here. No team getting a huge advantage.
Yeah, tooth and nail fight so far, guys. These sides match up really well.
Nunn with it. He's got six. Off the left rim and out.
Credit to D for not giving up on that play. He's a tough cover down low.
And Kelly Olynyk is going to pick up the foul. That's his fifth foul.
That's number five on him. No room for error anymore. I bet they'll take it at him right now. Try to get him out the game.
The Heat making a switch here. Strus is checked in. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Kuzma finds James. No good with the triple. The Heat have gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Nunn passes to Strus. Knocks it loose. Stolen by Caldwell Pope. Now the Lakers on the break. Flushes it down to finish the break.
I really like it when Caldwell Pope leaks out on the break. He just finds a way to get past defenders and creates chances for himself in the open floor.
Here's the three. Rebound, the Lakers. Harrell's got 6 rebounds in the game. Loads it up there for Harrell. Rebound by the Heat.
Yeah, and that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
Oh, I'm always surprised when it doesn't happen. I'm sure these two will have a good laugh about it later.
The Heat making a switch here. Achua's checked in. The Heat trail by 3. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Nunn against Schroeder buries the long-range jumper.
Well, maybe he's not a priority for the D, but come on, man. Gotta have somebody keeping track of him.
Now Harrell, 10 points for him. And it's Schroeder missing.
No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage.
Here's Nunn. And the rejection by Harrell. Here's Strus. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket. The Lakers shooting a troubling 38% in the third. Not the finest work of this offense.
And see, Webb, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope changing his approach before last season. He knew he wouldn't need to take on as much of a scoring responsibility.
Yeah, and what a team player, G.A. I mean, KCP rededicated himself to defense. He tries to do more with less touches now. And that's the mindset you need to have playing with stars going for a championship.
Andre Iguodala is checked in for Miami. Tyler Herro comes in for Kendrick Nunn. Pass to Harkless for the lead. It doesn't go for him. So the Lakers will take it the other way. Matthews scanning the floor. Here's Morris. Miami grabs the miss. And here is Iguodala. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Driving inside. Offensive rebound. L.A. has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Caruso kicks to Harrell. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8 night shooting.
Guys, not much more a defender can do in that situation. Harrell with the focus and the strength to just power through the contact.
Out to the right wing. There's the pick. Here's Strus. The shot's good. Strus has got the game tied up here for the Heat.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Harrell drives in. Second chance shot. And it's Iguodala with the rebound. Iguodala's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Pass to Harkless. Puts the fadeaway right on the money. And the Heat lead by 2.
Yeah, quick trigger. And from that range, if he senses the defenders have backed off, forget about it.
Knocked loose. Iguodala with it. Now guarded by Harrell. Harkless on the wing. From outside the arc. Morris with the rebound.
Not the most productive quarter he'll ever have, but his shot selection's been a little bit dubious.
Caruso, the pass to Horton Tucker. Fires for 3. It's hauled in by the Heat. Iguodala's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Launches a 3. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Iguodala's got the lead up to 5 now for the Heat.
Oh, and squaring up is Iguodala. Nice follow-through on the release.
Here's Achua. Here's Hero. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Morris. Los Angeles making a switch here. Gasol's checked in. Hero passes to Adebayo. Good ball movement here by Miami. Five on the clock. Miami needs to get a shot off, but they recover it. Here's Butler. Ball's knocked loose. Here's Caruso. And the last second attempt doesn't fall. The third quarter comes to a close. Heat lead by five. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. Let's listen in on what Eric Spoelstra had to say to his team.
It's got to be a sense of urgency right now, okay? Any kind of tip out or 50-50 ball, we got to own that. And then we got to communicate. I don't know, but it's got to be a real sense of urgency.
GA, he's begging his guys to be more assertive in all aspects of the game.
And in close games, Coach Spo is solid at knowing how to get his guys to just kick it up a notch.
And with three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ballgame. Caldwell Pope and LeBron fill out the wings. Montrezl Harrell is out there with Kyle Kuzma, and it's Schroeder in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. And it's Butler missing. Lakers trail by five. And there's the pass to Schroeder. And there's the drive. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Heat.
They based their offense around the three-point shot today, and that was the right move. It's been a huge weapon for them all game.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end.
And he makes the first. Schroeder hits them both. Now, here is Robinson. Pass to Adebayo. Now, here's Nunn. He's guarded by Schroeder. Nunn can't get it to fall. And so James will bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Caldwell Pope outside. It's good. This game is all even.
And Caldwell Pope can be a volume three-point shooter, meaning when he gets a lot of attempts from there, he can fill it up from downtown.
The Heat have gone 0-3 to start the fourth quarter. Pass to Nunn. Pass to Adebayo. Over Harrell. The shot by Adebayo, no good. And Los Angeles guys shooting 49% on the game. They'll take that. There's the pass to Harrell. Back to Schroeder. He takes it in. Count it. Good. And the Lakers lead by two.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
We see this all too often. You have to be willing to put in the work.
Nunn kicks to Robinson. The dish to Butler. They need this. A rebound by the Lakers. And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. It's Schroeder with the drive. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for Los Angeles?
Look, from mid-range, they've been deadly all day. It's really opened things up for them at the other end of the floor.
Yeah, but also give them credit for the layups they've had tonight after strong drives to the basket.
Thank you. That free throw, no good.
And missing opportunities here to extend that lead at the free throw line this half.
Good on the second free throw. Nunn with it. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
He kicks to Robinson. Butler against Caldwell Pope. Six to shoot.
It's been a huge night for Butler. I mean, here's a guy who can shoulder the load offensively any night.
James, the pass to Harrell. Caldwell Pope feeling it out a bit. Harrell, a screen on Olynyk. Los Angeles with another miss. Miami trailing. And stolen by LeBron. Nobody near Schroeder. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist.
An elite passer at his position. I mean, James always seems to make the right decision.
For Miami, they've gone just 1-6 from the field to start the fourth quarter. A bit of a slowdown for them right now. Schroeder against Nunn. Trying to get open is Adebayo. Nunn can't get it to fall. The 17-footer. Here's Kuzma. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It's going to be on Bam Adebayo.
Oh, constantly knocking on the defense's door. I like the way Kuzma plays in attack mode.
And the first one drops.
And many people are high on Kuzma, an all-around player with a promising future given his impressive skill set.
That one is no good. When Kuzma first entered the league, the Lakers were a rebuilding team. Now, Greg, he's one of the more experienced pieces on this team.
And Kuzma's made the most of it, switching to a learning role. Tries to absorb as much as he can from the vets, and he does everything he can to pick their brain and improve on those little things in terms of championship-caliber basketball.
Adebayo against Schroeder. Count it, and the Laker lead has been cut to just 3 points on the basket from Adebayo.
You see the offense coming around for Adebayo. Entered the league with raw skills, but he's had the benefit of great coaching.
Caldwell Pope passes to Kuzma. Harrell dishes to Schroeder. Six on the shot clock, and Harrell slams it in.
Oh, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. And stolen by James. The wide open look here for Kuzma. His three-pointers off the mark. The Heat trail by five. Now, Nunn. Passes it to Butler. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, that was the third straight high-percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Heroes checked in for Duncan Robinson.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Oh, Now, look, we all know Butler wants to win. He knows he's in the prime years of his career, and he's hungry for titles.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
Now, that's what coaches are paid to do, right? I mean, curious to see what they go with here.
And now, we present our New Balance Player of the Game, LeBron James.
And he's played this entire game on his front foot, Kevin. I mean, driving the lane, going to the rim with purpose, and getting those points the hard way.
Now, let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Frank Vogel talk to his team during the break. This game is close, and he told his players, hey, guys, this is when it's fun, right? This is a close game, and this is when you get to show what you're made of. Right here, right now. Kevin, we'll see how they respond.
Thank you, David. The drive by Schroeder. Kuzma finds James. Yep, that one goes. LeBron's got 21 in the game.
They couldn't have asked for much more from him today. He's been a key force in their offense.
And the Heat call time here. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
He's been a force inside. If they don't commit more bodies down low, he's going to keep destroying them in the paint.
Adebayo finds Olynyk. Good ball movement here by the Heat. None with it.
And that shot isn't the one they should be taking if they want to make this comeback happen.
Schroeder outside. Pass to Kuzma. And here is Harrell. Shot clock at 6. Picked by Harrell. LeBron, good. And now a six-point Laker lead.
And James is super strong, incredible at powering through the defense.
Adebayo with a screen on Schroeder. Takes it from 10. Butler against LeBron. Here's Nunn. Miami no good on that time either.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Oh, man. Awful display from him so far. But you know he's going to keep working to try to turn it around.
The Heat trail by 6. Going to the Adebayo. And stolen by Harrell. Butler against LeBron. Trying to get open is Kuzma. And that one's good by LeBron. LeBron's got 6 in the quarter.
Oh, powerful presence on the court. It's hard to match James' strength inside.
Butler against James. Olynyk, a screen on LeBron. Butler passes to Olynyk.
If Olynyk gets you in a bad spot when you're on him, he'll never let you off the hook.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And no good as the first free throw missing for him. We'll see if he can nail the second.
And Kelly Olynyk from a basketball family. His father, a successful coach. His mother, a scorekeeper. He's grown up around the game.
And he ends up making the second, and that narrows the gap to 7.
Boy, Heat sure like to have that miss back. Hard to chip away at a lead when you're leaving freebies at the line.
And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
Yeah, I love how they played for one another out there. No signs of selfishness. They're just a total team effort.
Here's Butler. Count that one.
Oh, extremely active on both ends of the floor. Butler shrugs off contact.
Here's Schroeder. LeBron outside. That one, no good. Some solid defense from Butler.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
He hits the first one, and that trims the lead to 6. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. And the Lakers call time here. They lead by 5. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. And here is Los Angeles now. And he commits the intentional foul. Timeout called. The Lakers. They're leading by 5. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Four seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And so they foul intentionally. hits the first, and that increases their lead to 6. And he cannot convert on the second. That misses. Now a timeout called by Miami. They're trailing by 6. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
No time to waste on this possession.
Yeah, they got to get it to the plate fast and execute. It's your only hope.
Olynyk. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. And they go to the intentional foul. One boy, he wanted that one to fall. That's good, going 1 of 2 from the line, and that makes it a 7-point lead. Olynyk the pass to Hero. Knocks down the trifecta.
You can count on Olynyk to move the ball quickly when he spots an open teammate. And that feed was phenomenal.
And now an intentional foul. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game out.
He drops the first one, and that puts them up by 5. And so both free throws are good, and it's a 6-point ball game.
And it's a wrap. Any chance they may have had for a comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
And so the Lakers take the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, but I really got a sense that the fans gave them that emotional boost that was needed down the stretch. This crowd, man, they were electric.
And we've got David Aldridge standing by on our sideline with the player of the game. David, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. LeBron, you have accomplished so much in this league. How have you sustained it for this long?
You know, it's only a select few. It's not many who make it to this point. And I would never take the game for granted. That's why I try to give everything I can till I can't give no more. And I've been around some great players, great coaches, great organizations. And for me to have this opportunity right here means a lot, and I'm very humble.
Well, we appreciate all the work you've put in, man. Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Chris Webber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.